Here in Europe, we are in the middle of our winter, but already looking forward to summer. So let's connect to sunny Santiago de Chile and check in with Pablo Olivares from SQM to get a forecast of regulatory developments in Latin America. Hi Pablo, what are the most notable developments in your region in 2021?
Hello dear. Over the last years, we've heard the intentions of Mexico, Brazil, Argentina and Chile on moving forward with their chemicals management programs. But I think at this point, Colombia is winning the bold position on this. So let's start with them. Recently, the Colombian government had just published a new version of their chemicals decree, establishing a chemical inventory. So under this chemical inventory, all chemical substances imported or manufactured over 100 kilograms per year will need to be notified to this inventory. And the information that manufacturers and importers will need to notify is basically the identification of the substance, the annual quantity imported or manufactured of the substance, the hazard classification, and also the identified uses. With this information, the Colombian government will also prioritize substances that will be subject to a further registry. There are no clear details or much more details on what will be the criteria for that prioritization. And also in this decree, they're also including the requirement for risk assessment for those substances that have not been included in the inventory or that their uses that have not been included in the inventory.
Okay, and how about the developments of the Mexican policy for sound chemicals management?
Well, Mexico is also moving forward in terms of regulatory developments to close certain gaps for their chemicals management. In 2019, the Mexican General Health Council made a proposal with provisions for the registry of chemical substances. And according to the provisions of this proposal, companies will have 2 years to present a registration dossier, which includes information about the identification of the chemical substance, physicochemical properties, toxicological information, ecotoxicological information, chemical safety assessment, and GHS classification and practice. On the other hand, industry via ANIC is proposing to start establishing an inventory in order to close these gaps at this point.
Good to see things are moving forward in Mexico. Anything special happening in Brazil or Argentina?
In the case of Brazil, in 2018, there was a first proposal for a chemicals management system, which was shelved under Bolsonaro's administration in 2019. Then a Brazilian congressman was proposing a new bill establishing a chemical inventory, but not a whole chemicals management system. And at the end of last year, there is a new proposal which is being discussed in Congress, which also counts with support from industry, workers, and civil society. So we might have some news from Brazil in the near future. In the case of Argentina, we know that in 2019, they started to discuss in Congress a bill on chemicals management, which established provisions for the generation of a national inventory, which will require manufacturers and importers to provide information on the identification of substances, the annual quantity of the product imported or manufactured in Argentina, the recommended uses and the SDS. And also it's including provisions for the risk assessment of prioritized substances.
And in your home country, Chile?
Well, in the case of Chile, I have some very interesting and fresh news. We know that last week the Controller General approved the decree implementing GHS in Chile, which is also important to take into account is that this regulation is not just implementing a classification, labeling and SDS requirements, but it's also establishing provisions for the establishing of a chemical inventory. So manufacturers and importers will need to notify the identity of substances above 1 ton per year. Also their hazard classification, intended uses, and in the case of substances as such, manufacturers and importers will need to submit the safety attachments of that substance. This regulation is also introducing the concept of risk assessment for certain substances. More details on what which substances will be subject to risk assessment will be developed in a complementary regulation. So for the time being, there is no much information about it. Also important to note that GHS implementation in Chile is following a CLP.
CLP in Chile, interesting. The Latin America Regulatory Cooperation Forum encourages local authorities to establish regulatory cooperation. What are the current best practices and how does this facilitate chemical industry in Latin America?
We are certainly very happy about the work that this Latin American Regulatory Cooperation Forum is doing. It has helped members to exchange experience and try to work on regulatory convergence in the regions, which we know it's quite challenging. In terms of best practices, this group is basically advocating that regulatory developments are basically based on science, that management programs are also based on risk, that regulatory developments is considering the participation of different stakeholders, and that we try to follow as much as possible international standards available. We certainly believe that if we follow these best practices, both industry and the public sector, but especially the users of chemical products will certainly benefit.
Pablo, thank you very much for the information. Enjoy summer, and we are looking forward to spring.